डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड फेलोज, वेलकम टू अवर टुडे लेक्चर। इन द प्रीवियस टू लेक्चर वी डिस्कस हाउ टू चेक द स्टेशनरिटी ऑफ द टाइम सीरीज डाटा एंड द पैनल डाटा। टुडे लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ टू इंटरप्रेट एंड हाउ टू एस्टिमेट ओएलएस। ओके, व्हाट इज द क्राइटेरिया for running the OLS estimator? If your all variable are stationarity at level, then you can apply OLS. If your some variable are stationary at level and some variable are stationary at first difference, then you cannot apply OLS. So before applying OLS, you have to check the stationarity of the variable. If your all variable are stationary at the level, then you can apply OLS. If your variables are not stationary at level, then you cannot apply OLS. So I am assuming that my all variable are stationary at the level. Okay, but when you want to do estimation by using OLS, you have to check by yourself that your variable are stationary at the level or not. As I told you in my previous lecture that how can you check the stationarity of the level, so you can do by yourself. Now in this lecture we are going to start how to run and how to interpret the result of OLS estimator. So first of all, go to file, new work file. Enter the data, start date and end date. My data starts from 1975 and the end date of my data is 2018. So I have annually data, so I select the annual option from this. This option contain three series: unstructured, undated, dated and balance panel data. I am using time series data. So I will select dated regular frequency as I have a start and end date for my data. Now click OK. Go to the Excel file, copy the data. Now go again back to the iViews file, go to quick, go to empty group, click here and the paste selected data. So here is the data of your all variables. Okay, there are certain methods, certain ways to estimate the OLS. You can write the command here and run the OLS estimator. If you don't want to do by command method, then you can do it by another method. I am going with the other method. We have four variable: CPI, GDP, interest rate and M2. Okay, C for constant and this resid mean residual. Okay, so if you are not using the command option and you are doing by other method, then you have to select the dependent variable first. Okay, like I am going to do. Let's suppose I have GDP, my dependent variable. So I will select GDP first, then press control and then select all the variables one by one. Okay, what is the main thing? The main thing is that if you are not using command file and you are going with the other option, then select your dependent variable first, then press the control button and then select all of your other variables. Okay, after selecting the variables, right click, go to open, open as equation, okay, and click on it. So when you click on it, here the first variable will be your dependent variable and after that all variables are independent. Okay, C is for constant. I will delete it from here and write after the dependent variable. Okay, so here is my complete equation. which means that GDP is dependent on CPI, interest rate, and M2. Okay. This option contains the list of econometrics technique or econometrics method for estimation. We will discuss about these all methods in our upcoming lectures. So now we are discussing OLS method. So here is the option for OLS method, least square method. Click on it. Okay. And press okay. And here are the result. Okay. So now we will discuss that how can you interpret the results. So here you can see that our dependent variable is GDP, method least square. This is showing the sample of our data, and it is showing how many number of observation are included our data. Okay. So now this is constant. It means that how much variation is due to those variable which are not included in the model. Okay. Constant. When all other variable are zero, then this variable then constant shows the variation to the dependent variable. Okay. So now let's discuss all these results one by one. First of all, let's talk about the independent variable, their coefficients, standard error, t statistic, and the probability value. Okay, so let's talk about the coefficient value and the coefficient sign. As we know that our dependent variable is GDP and our first independent variable is CPI. Okay, as the coefficient sign of CPI is positive, which means that there exists a positive relationship between CPI and GDP. Okay, what does it mean? As the coefficient sign is positive, which means that there exists a positive relationship between CPI and GDP. When CPI increases, GDP also increases. When CPI decreases, GDP also decreases. We are not talking about what is economic theory. I am just going to explain the results. Okay. Here is the standard error and the t statistic value. Okay. For the significance of the variable, it is important that the probability value must be less than the 0.05%. Okay. If your probability value is not less than 0.05%, it means that your variable is not significant. As in this case, our variable coefficient, our variable probability is greater than 0.05, which means that this variable is not significant. Okay. So what you have to do? First, you have to check the coefficient sign. The sign tell you about the relationship between the independent and dependent variable. Its sign is positive, which means that there exists a positive relationship between CPI and GDP. And the next step, you have to check that what is the probability value. If the probability value is less than 0.05, it means that your variable is significant. If the probability value is greater than 0.05, it means that your variable is not significant. As in this case, our probability value is greater than 0.05, which means that this variable is not showing significant impact or effect on the dependent variable. I will write here, if the p value is less than 0.05, then the variable is showing significant impact on the dependent variable. Okay, if the p value is greater than 0.05, then variable is not significant. Okay, you can check the significance of the variable by another method, by looking at the t value. If the t value is greater than 2, okay, you have to check these t statistic value by ignoring the sign negative. You take these value in absolute form, okay, ignore this minus sign. If this t statistic value is greater than 2, then your variable is significant. But in this case, our variable t statistic value is less than 2, which means that this variable is not significant. And the same result is told by probability value. Probability value also tell us that this variable is not significant, and its t value is also showing that this variable is not significant. Okay, if the t value, t statistic value is greater than 2, then this variable is significant. If the t statistic value is less than 2, then this variable is not significant. Okay, so this t statistic value is calculated? This t statistic value is calculated by using coefficient and standard error. If you divide this coefficient with standard error, then you will get t statistic value. Okay, if you divide this coefficient by this standard error, then you will get the t statistic value for this variable. So let's talk about the another variable, which is IR, and IR stand for interest rate. Okay, let's first look at its coefficient sign. Its coefficient sign is negative, which means that there exists a negative relationship between interest rate and GDP. When interest rate increases, GDP decreases. When interest rate decreases, GDP increases. Okay, this negative sign means that there exists a negative relationship between this variable and this dependent variable. Okay, and let's talk about its probability value. As its probability value is less than 0.05 or equals to 0.05 mostly, okay, it is exact 0.05, so it means that this variable is significant. Okay, and its t statistic value is also 2, which means that this variable is significant. Okay, if the t statistic value is 2 or greater than 2, it indicates that the variable is significant. And if the probability value is 0.05 or less than 0.05, which means that this variable is significant. Okay, and third variable sign is also negative, which means that this variable have negative relationship with our dependent variable. Okay, when this increases, the dependent variable decreases. When this variable decreases, the value of this variable increases. Okay, and its probability value is greater than 0.05, which means that this variable is not significant. And its t statistic value is also less than 2, which means that this variable is not significant. This variable is not showing significant effect on our dependent variable. Okay, And let's talk about how to interpret these results. What does this coefficient value mean? As this is our independent variable and this is our dependent variable, so how we interpret these results? Okay, this 7047.26 mean that when there is 1 unit increase in CPI, it will increase the GDP by 7047.267 unit. Okay, I will repeat it again. What does this coefficient value of CPI means? As there is positive sign, so it means that when there is 1 unit increase in CPI, it will increase the GDP by 7047.26 unit. Okay, and what about interest rate? When there is 1 unit increase in IR, it will decrease the GDP by 182270.70 units. Okay, similarly M2 has negative sign, which means that when M2 increases by 1 unit, it will decrease the GDP by 0.04 units. Okay, now let's talk about these results. What does this mean? Okay, Akaki, Schwarz, Hanan, these three criteria are used for lag selection criteria. We will discuss these three in our upcoming lectures, as in OLS we did not include the lag, so there is no need to explain these results in case of OLS, as they are used for lag selection criteria. Okay, what does this R-square show? This R-square shows that how much variation in your dependent variable is because of these independent variable. Okay, this R-square shows that how much variation in your dependent variable is because of these independent variable. As its value is 0.11, which means that 11% variation in the GDP is because of these three variable. Okay, which is very low. For the significance and for the efficient result of your model, this R square value must be greater than 60% or 70%. As long as this R square have high value, it indicates that your result are much better or good. Your model is good. Let's suppose if this R square have here 90, okay, 90.90. What does it mean? It means that 90% variation in GDP is because of your these three independent variable, and it is very good model if the value of R square is greater than 90 or greater than 80. Everything which is greater than 70% is acceptable. Okay, the less value of R square means that your independent variable are not explaining your dependent variable. So why this very R square value is very less? Because we have include three independent variable in our model, and out of them two variable are highly insignificant. Okay, our two independent variable are highly insignificant. So that's why this R square value is very low. So keep in mind, when you are selecting your independent variable, build a economic theory. So you have to relate with your dependent variable. Try to think in your mind that how your independent variable are related to your dependent variable. Now talk about this adjusted R square. This adjusted R square shows the variation in R square when you add or drop some variable in your model. Okay. And this standard error of regression, it shows that how far your estimated values are far from the fitted value or the actual value. Okay. What does this standard error of regression shows? It shows that how far away your estimated value are from the fitted value. Okay. If this standard error have low values or close to zero, which mean that your estimated and actual values are on same point, which is a very, very good model if its value is close to zero or exact one. But if the standard error regression values are high, it means that your estimated values are very far, far away from the fitted value. As in this case, the standard error regression value is very much high, which means that this model's calculated values or the estimated values are very much far away from the fitted values. Okay. So what does this sum square residual mean? This sum square residual mean that how much variation is not explained by your variables which are you included in the model. Okay, what does this sum square residual mean? This sum square residual shows that how much variation is not or cannot be explained by your variable. If its value is close to zero, it means that 0% variation is not explained by your variable, which is very good. Okay, try to understand it. Larger the value of sum squared, it means that your model is not good fitted. Less the value of sum squared mean that there is very less portion of the variation which cannot be explained by your variable, but the greater portion is explained by your variable. So if sum squared residual value is high, it means that your model is not good fitted. If your sum squared residual value is close to zero or zero, then it means that your model is very good fitted. Okay. And what is f-stat and probability f-stat value? F-stat and probability f-stat values show that your overall model is good fitted or not. If the p-value of f-statistic, this is p-value of f-statistic, if it is less than 0.05, it means that your overall model is good fitted. But if the p-value of f-stat is greater than 0.05, it means that your model is not good fitted. Okay. I will try to write the explanation here. If the p value of f stat is less than 0.05, then your overall model is good fitted. But if the p value is greater than 0.05, then your overall model is not good fitted. Okay, so what will be the null and alternative hypothesis? The null hypothesis is that model is not good fitted, and the alternative hypothesis is that model is good fitted. Okay, as I told you earlier that if probability value is less than 0.05, then model is good fitted, and if the p value is greater than 0.05, which means that model is not good fitted. If the p value is less than 0.05, we have to reject the H naught. Okay, as in our case the probability value is greater than 0.05. When the probability value is greater than 0.05, we have to accept the H naught. By accepting the H naught, it means that our model is not good fitted. Okay, if the p value is less than 0.05, we will reject the H naught. If the p value of F statistic is greater than 0.05, then we have to accept the H naught, which means that our model is not good fitted. Okay, so what does this Durbin-Watson tell us? The Durbin-Watson value, the Durbin-Watson test, the Durbin-Watson stats tell us about the existence of the autocorrelation in our data. If the value of Durbin-Watson is between 1.5 to 2.5, it means that there is no autocorrelation in our data. Okay, if the Durbin-Watson DW, if the Durbin-Watson value is between 1.5 to 2.5, then it means that there is no auto correlation in the data. But if it is less than 1.5 or greater than 2.5, then it indicates that there exists the problem of auto correlation in the data. As our results of Durbin-Watson's value is less than 1.5, which means that there exists a problem of autocorrelation in our data. Okay, I hope that today lecture is somehow give you new knowledge. If you have any query or question, you can ask me.